Hello everyone, Francesco Cipollone here, or Frank for Friend. Today, we want to conclude a very, very intense week with the analysis of Shai-Hulud that has hit 504 repository compromised. And I think this is a new generation of supply chain vulnerabilities, because I believe we are in stage two or three stage attack, where the NX previous attacks was just a test to test the malware capability. You can see the previous blog with the attacking technique that are very, very similar. It follows the same pattern of an attacker compromising one of the maintainer and a set of libraries. This was caught very, very quickly. Now, this methodology and this technique is a little bit more sophisticated because infected one maintainer, but itself replicated, stole credential, and they use a very interesting technique, creating the Shai-Hulud repo in your GitHub repo, opening to everyone, stealing credential with TruffleHog, that is a well-known open source tool that is fantastic, but it was weaponized. And also we've seen effect of vibe coding in this type of attack from the code and from some slightly mistakes here and there. And then the credentials were exfiltrated on a webhook site that is a open source site to host credentials. And then the effect was that the worm was self-replicating, stealing credentials and trying to go to other maintainer. Now, James Berthotti has done a wonderful analysis of the first supply chain and this new supply chain, so I'm not going to go in detail on this, but what I want to do today is analyze and go through the various resources that we put together. The first analysis blog with the QXI account compromise, the full analysis blog with the TinyColor second phase attack and all of the library, we are 504 today. With all of these libraries, you can see compromise, including CrowdStrike native library and the effect and how to defend against this. Now, as you can see here, we're trying to replicate the stage of the attack into the four phases from the 88th of September all the way down to the 15th initial attack that then accelerated between the 16 and 17 and the 18 today, where the majority of the attack is present. You can play with the graph that we put together. But what the worm does, as you can see, there was an acceleration on the attack, and a lot of the package were, aside from CrowdStrike, a lot of the package were web front-end and web facing. We put together an open source script that you can run. As you can see, you can run, we can simulate. We provide as well simulated packages, but fundamentally detect the vulnerabilities and helped you fundamentally see them in Phoenix if you want to use Phoenix, but it's open source and enable you to visualize those vulnerability as a report wherever you want. We want to help the community getting together, but also there is a minus minus Phoenix in the script that you can run, and this upload fundamentally those packages in Phoenix, create them, tags them, and then fundamentally give you the output of the report. But going back to the compromised script, as you can see, some of that are on core utils. This particular worm tried to replicate across and try to maintain presence. And fundamentally, we've seen in the attack, the four stages of the attack, the compromise, and which packages were more kind of targeted, and the acceleration of the self-replicating worm. Now, this is a very unique attack, because it's not just a supply chain that attack one specific packages or a series of packages or a maintainer, but this is the initial vector. So fundamentally, you have the initial stage of attack through a persona that then jumps to the package that you maintain, is still credential, and then it tries to get to another persona and try to move laterally towards all of the package that it can get hold on. So this is a very particular attack methodology that we've seen, and it's been spread across multiple stages. So I do believe that this is just the second phase of the singularity attack, as it's been renamed, or Shai-Hulud, because of the name of the folder. Now, I don't believe this is the final stage, but this is the final stage of the second stage attack, where we're going to see in the future more compromise and a weaponization of a lot of the credentials that were stolen here, because we've seen the weaponization of the credentials that were stolen in the first phase of the attack. As James mentioned in his video, this phase, the first phase of the attack, or the QXI compromise, leverage some of the credential in this particular attack to then deploy the current compromise. Now, if you want a full analysis, of course, you have the various stages here on the article, how it moved, or if you want the full analysis of which packages were affected, you can see it here on phoenix.security. We hope this is useful. As I said, we open source the detector of the Shai-Hulud, and the information are here. Please contribute, fork, make it yours. This generate a local assessment, so it helps you and helps your peers getting up to speed with this unique supply chain attack. Now, if you want to fix this particular version of the attack, you need to pin the version while you upgrade the library. So remove the auto fix and auto upgrade. Now, I know that from a security perspective, this is unprecedented to say stay on the previous version, but because we are in this mix of an attack, I would say this is strongly recommended to stay on specific version until this is kind of sorted out. And then if you can prevent fundamentally your developer to go publicly to NPM or any other package manager, but try to have them going through a central place that has sanitized packages and not directly to NPM or any package manager. As well, you can block with a proxy disconnection and pin the version, or help everybody pin the version to a specific healthy version. And you have in the blog the various version, the recommendation, and the compromise version, and the Phoenix script as well. When it generates the version, generates also the recommended version to go to, and we try to keep this as updated as possible. But again, try to pin the version, try to block access directly to NPM, either through DNS injection or through a single place where developer can come and go to get their packages. Stay safe out there. I'm going to put the link of a lot of these resources, but they are available in the blog, phoenix.security, and there is a series of blogs on the topic. Stay safe out there. We're in together, and let's try to avoid the next phase of attack by being prepared today. This is Francesco Cipollone, CEO and co-founder of Phoenix Security. Stay safe. Goodbye.